Now we are going to discuss about the topic of measurements of distance and directions. In that measurement of distance, that is how the way we are going to measure the distance and what are all the direct methods are available to measure the distance and if there are any corrections or whatever it is that we are going to, how the way we are going to do those corrections. These things we are going to discuss under this topic. First one, measurement of linear distance. The distance between two station points are called the linear distance. It has been measured with the help of, by means of three different methodology. One is direct measurements. Second one is measurements by optical means. Third one, electromagnetic methods. In direct measurements, we are going to have our instrument like chain, tape. Okay, now these things are comes under direct measurements. Measurement by optical means, like theodolite. Then tachyometer. These things are comes under measurement by optical means. Third one is electromagnetic methods. That means our total stations, which runs under electromagnetic waves. Okay, so by using those instruments, if we are going to calculate the distance, then it should comes under electromagnetic method. Now we can discuss it briefly. So in measurements of methods, linear measurements. Okay, now there are three methods. One is direct measurements, optical means, and electronic methods. So direct methods, there are these categories such as pacing, pasometer, pedometer, speedometer. Okay, these are all the things which comes under direct measurements, along with chain, tape, those things. Optical means, by means of our theodolite, then tachyometric, okay, with the help of leveling instruments, we are going to find out the distance, then it comes under optical means. Then electromagnetic methods, with the help of electronic waves, if we are going to get the data or get the distance, then those things are comes under electronic methods. Total station is the best example for this. Now, whenever we are going for the linear measurement of linear distances, okay, now at that time we have to get only the horizontal distance, not the sloping distance. So if you are getting the sloping distance, then you have to do once again to get the horizontal distance. Okay, even if your ground is sloping ground, then you have to get a horizontal distance, like the way your methodology should be. And here the example shows. So this is our ground profile or our land profile. Okay, the end A and B, we need the distance. So we have to measure the horizontal distance between the point A and B. Okay, not the, so this is correct, not the inclined distance between the point A and B. So likewise, our methodology should be. Here in this figure, it shows the point B is here, point A is in the sloping ground. Okay, now how the way they are getting to, the person, one person is standing at point B and he is stretching the tape tightly, and another person is at point A, he is standing vertically and holding the chain or tape on his head, as well as he holding the plumb bob to maintain the verticality of the point. Meanwhile, he is in a need of level bubble, okay, for maintaining the horizontal position of the tape or chain. Okay, now so that he can get the exact horizontal distance between the point A and B. So this is the correct distance for the point A and B. Now the another methodology, that is the direct measurements to find out the distances. Okay, so first one is pacing. Pacing is nothing but by walk you have to get the distance between two station points. Here how the way we are going to, okay, so we just measure the distance between two steps, consecutive steps, that is called the pacing distance. Okay, now and by walk we are going to cover the points. So meanwhile we have to count the number of steps we have taken to reach the particular point. Now the distance between the points, which is equal to pacing distance multiplied with number of paces, will give our distance. Second one is measurement with piezometer. So piezometer is nothing but the device which is going to record the number of paces by means of our body vibration. Okay, here no need to count the number of steps which you have taken to reach the particular point, but we have to count the pace length. Okay, so now the total distance, which is equal to average pace length multiplied with number of paces or steps. Okay, now this one we can get it from the device. Then third one, pedometer. Pedometer is nothing but the device which is going to record number of steps, and we can give the input value, that is our pace length, in the instrument itself, so that it can count the number of steps through the body motion, as well as our, based on our pace length, it can display the value of entire distance which we have covered by walk. So this is the another device. And fourth one, odometer or speedometer. We all know that our bike, car, we can have, okay, and the speedometer. Here we are going to note this will give our distance covered. Okay, so wherever we need that particular point, we can note down our initial reading, and we can run along the next point, consecutive point, so that the automatically it will count to the number of, that is what is the distance. So the difference between the first point reading to last point reading will give your distance covered. And whatever we have discussed, those four methods, it can be suitable for only leveled ground. If we can have undulation in the ground or ups and downs in the field, it never suits, since it may give some reading or some value with the error. So we cannot rectify that error too. This method or the rough method, and to be used in preliminary survey, and its accuracy of value, which lies between 1 in 50 to 1 in 200. Okay, so the next, in order to get the accuracy of error, sorry, in order to get the accuracy of work, and even though the ground is undulated, then we can able to get the horizontal distance. That's why we came out to another process, that is called chaining. Okay, so either chain or tape can be utilized for this measurement system. This is the another type of direct measurement and accurate method of direct measurement system. So here the precision of work has been ensured between 1 in 1000 to 1 in 5000 for ordinary land surveying. Okay. So chimes has been used at a earlier stage. Nowadays we are using only tape for ease of work. So instruments used for chain surveying are chaining. Okay. So there are 5 different chains are available. Okay, now one is metric chain, another one is Gunter's chain or surveyor's chain, third one is engineer's chain, fourth one is revenue chain, and fifth one is steel band. Okay, this is based on their length and material. Okay, normally earlier stage all the chain has been manufactured with the help of steel, iron. Okay, now the metric chain, it has the length of 20 to 30 meter in length, and totally it have 100 links. So based on their length, the link, each link length has been differed with respect to either 0.2 meter or 0.3 meter, and at the end it have brass handles to hold it steadily and perfectly, and all the chains have handles to hold it for holding purpose. Then Gunter's chain or surveyor's chain, it has the length of 66 feet and has the 100 links, so that each link have the length of 0.6 feet. And whenever we are doing the survey, the 10 square chain will give 1 acre for that purpose. So whenever we are going for dividing the land in form of each acres, okay, now at the time we have used this Gunter's chain. Okay, and engineer's chain, it has the length of 100 feet and it has 100 links, so that each link have the length of 1 feet. And revenue chain, 33 feet, it has the links of 16 in number. So that next one is steel band or band chain, it has the length of either 20 meter or 30 meter. So here the figure shows the metric chain. So this is brass handle, this is 20 meter chain, so it at the end it has the brass handle, and each and every meter it has some link, some rings like this. Okay, so at the every meter it has the brass rings. Okay, now each and every 1 meter length it has the brass rings, and every, okay, 1 meter and 9 meter it has the ring like this. Okay, single V. Okay, now and sorry this kind, and 2 meter and 8 meter it has the V shape profile link. Okay, now double V profile is at 3 meter and 7 meter. Triple V profile is at 4 meter and 6 meter, and at the end of 5 meter, each 5 meter, 5, 10, 15 and 20, okay, 15, okay, now at the stage it can have the ring like this. Okay, so this is your 20 meter and 30 meter chain. Even our 30 meter chain, at every 5 meter distance we have the ring like this. Okay, in order to read the reading easily in the field, we want to calculate from the beginning, that is from 0 meter. Okay, now by seeing the tag itself we can find out this is the 5 meter, this is 10 meter and plus what is the link. Based on counting the links from the origin of tag, we can calculate the entire distance. So for the ease of purpose they have made like this. So here the figure shows the one type of surveyor's chain, engineer's chain. It has the length of 100 feet in the handle. So each chain has its length, okay, now at its handle, so that we can identify easily either 20 meter or 30 meter or 100 feet or 66 feet like that. Okay. Next, different types of tape. Based on tape manufacturing material we can classify that. One is cloth or linen tape, metallic tape, steel tape, Invar tape. Okay, these are all the four types of tapes available in the field. Next, instrument used for chining or taping. Okay, along with the chine or tape, we are in need of some accessories. Those accessories are arrows, pegs, ranging rods, offset rods, plumb bob, and cross tops. So here arrows are like this. Okay, in order to wherever we need or wherever we can have our substation points, at that place we are going to place these pegs and arrows. Next, the ranging rods and offset rods. So ranging rods and ranging rods has the height of either 2 meter or 3 meter. Okay, no, and it have alternate bands of red and white, or white or black, like that. Okay, no, alternative band it has. Okay, no, so each band has its height of either 20 centimeter or 30 centimeter based on its total height. Okay, now we could come for our offset rod. Offset rod also has the length of either 2 meter or 3 meter. It has the bandwidth of 25 centimeter each. Okay, now, and the difference between our ranging rod and offset rod is the shape. Okay, now, cross sectional details. Okay, now, ranging rod has the cross section of circular in shape, but our offset rod has the profile of square. Plumb bob used to maintain the verticality. Okay, now, here ranging rod has to be placed at the station points, wherever we are having the station point, either triangulation station or traverse station, at that place we are going to fix it. Offset rod is used to find the distance, okay, no, of nearby objects, nearby features from the station points. So next, cross staff. It is the device used to find the perpendicularity of the baseline point. Okay, now, so from the baseline, wherever we are having points, okay, now, for the points we are going to get the perpendicularity from the baseline. Okay, so for this purpose we are going to use cross staff. So next principles of chine surveying. Okay, the main principle of chine surveying is to divide the entire field into number of pieces of triangles. Those triangles should be well conditioned triangles. Okay, this is the principle of chine surveying. So how the way we are going to make it, that is through some process, those process to be discussed right now. One is ranging. So ranging is nothing but where the here station A and B are available. Okay, now during the survey we can have the station points A and B. There is nothing but our A and B is available. Now this is our main survey line. So we are in need of to find the distance between these two points. Okay, we can have either our chine or tape. Okay, now it has the maximum length of 30 meter. If these points, the distance between these points is more than 30 meter, then we are in need of to erect a substation points in between the line. Okay, so that point also should be in a straight line of this point. Okay, so the point A and B are the traverse station. So in between that we are going to erect a substation point. Okay, now at a distance of 30 meter interval. So whatever the process involved to make the intermediate points between the main survey line is called ranging. So the definition for ranging is the process of fixing intermediate points between the two survey stations in the chain line is called ranging. So there are two methodology to fix the intermediate points. One is direct ranging, another one is indirect ranging. Direct ranging means by means of naked eye or line ranger we can do. Here the starting point A and ending point B are intervisible to each other. At the time we can go with direct ranging. Indirect ranging or reciprocal ranging. Here the two station points A and B are not visible to each other. Like it may be the hill is presented in between that. So whatever the process we are going to do to make the intermediate points in the line of in the chain line of AB is called indirect or reciprocal ranging. So here I have given the video link for the indirect ranging and similarly for direct ranging. So by using that we can get some clear idea about the process.